Welcome to the Immaterial Gamers Podcast.
Woof is the word that can be described before we start this podcast. Remember to key in.
Oh, yeah. That bad, eh?
Yeah. Probably in terms of Europe, or if you're a League of Legends fan, it's probably the worst week. But we'll get there soon.
Eventually.
Yeah, we'll probably get there sooner than we think, because I reckon what's been played is going to be a short one. But let's do this. This is the Immaterial Gamers Podcast, episode 105. This is officially the first podcast after 2 years of Immaterial Gamers. And kind of popped it already. So
you went all fancy and popped it.
Yeah. And then used a fan to immediately get the sulfur smell out of there. So yeah, anyway. I've got to be careful about stuff falling in front of the camera. Before we started this podcast, I was getting everything set up, but finishing off the prep, and a giant ass spider decided. I heard the noise. I was like, what was that? He like literally fell in front of me, and then it stood there and it looked at me and it was like, hello. And I was like, hi. Do you want to piss off now? No, I'll stay on your table. That's fine. There's a dog outside.
Yes, there is.
Not much you can do about that, apparently. No. So, yeah, it's Ryan, it's D, and it's the damn dog. Yappy little bastard.
You can hear it.
Yeah.
You can tell it's one of the little gets.
It's barking at the chickens next door. Told you they was organised.
Chickens, where are they?
It's Chicken Run. It's Chicken Run. So, yeah. How's that? Okay then, cool.
I've been doing the rebuild this week. I mean, I've been putting physical parts together and trying to get this OS sorted out and crap.
Yep.
And terabytes of downloading and sorting.
Yep, and I did remote assistance on one of those bits.
Yeah, because the audio was like, yeah.
Do you want to admit to it?
Yeah, first time I installed the CD drive, completely went woof on the fact that I needed to install the drivers from Logitech.
Yes.
Or Realtek.
D didn't install the drivers for the sound card. To...
Yeah, that was
that's good. Fixed now.
Yeah.
So we've learned of at that point, the app Quick Assist on Windows 10. It's a bit iffy, but it's a better remote connection software than the remote desktop connection service that doesn't work.
Mm-hmm. Well, we also learned, I learned a few things this week, actually, on that one, on the hardware side.
Oh, yeah?
Well, one, I got a case and was a dud fan, but that's... minor thing. The other thing is, you know the M2 slots?
I'll say yes.
It's the new, it's like a buff, it's like a small slot on the new motherboard. It's the, you put a little like 250, like quarter gigs, half a gigs of space, but it's faster than SSD.
Yeah.
It's where I put the OS. It doesn't come with a tiny, it has a tiny nano screw. Like, you can't freaking see the damn thing. It didn't come with it.
Why not?
Apparently the manufacturers go, you don't need it. Oh, you need it, but I'm not going to give it you.
Well, they clearly did need it.
Seeing this hole in the motherboard where you screw it down.
Yeah.
So I had to go to the computer shop and get a special screw that was like £3.
Oh dear.
Along with the new case. It's just one of those like little inconveniences. So when you're ordering... if you're ordering an M2 slot, probably need to order the screw too.
Well, there is the more you know. I could probably actually get that sound effect and just add it in.
One of those little, but the N2 is pretty fast. I'll give it that. Mm. It is good. And it's now coming down in price. It was like, it came out with 7th gen. The 7th, about gen 7. In them boards above. So 2016, 2017.
Mm-hmm.
Generation boards and higher. They basically, you put your OS on that for that little git. It was like 300 quid. It's now down to about 50 quid for a 256 gig.
Oof.
So it's not that bad. It was like 300 and now it's like 50.
Fair dues. Fair dues.
But yeah, it's definitely good for the OS. But it's not good. It's good to have the OS and some key components because it's about the size of a, you know, a memory card?
Yeah.
Like a standard USB memory card thing.
Mm-hmm.
About that. But it's like faster than SSD.
Okay, cool.
But yeah, that's hardware stuff. I've been dealing with hardware all week.
Yeah. I've just been... I got the edits all done pretty quickly for the upcoming week's videos. So, the role-playing... RPN, which now just stands for role-playing Not In My Games and Nel2 Games. That's what it is at the moment because of the co-piloting for it.
This Coliseum.
Yeah.
What we actually did quite well on.
Yeah, made some progress. Yesterday's video, as you're watching the podcast, if you watched it when it comes out, is episode 14 of Persona, which I'm going to be a bit awkward on the fact that it's definitely getting deranked because the episode title's called Send Nudes.
Hmm.
I might have to find a creative way around it, to be honest. And that's everything up to date. Fantasy League is going strong, and if you can see in the back there, that's the Fantasy League trophy that I created with the blood, sweat, and respect of my own two hands, and certainly didn't repurpose.
An old trophy from somewhere.
Yeah. Not at all. It's going to be polished. It's going to be everything's fine. It'll be absolutely great. And it's going to be an absolute ball ache if it eventually goes over to Canada.
Well, we'll just... I mean,
we're still looking at the leaderboard for this. And for those who haven't watched the league...
You haven't got a 3D scanner. Doesn't a 3D scanner can't even side?
3D fax.
Yeah, 3D fax. Print it. It's fine.
Yeah, if only.
In the near future, that might actually be a thing.
If
3D comes down. Well, 3D is getting more common, and it's actually kind of affordable.
Yeah, like low-grade stuff you can get like a couple of hundred quid now. It's the higher-grade stuff that's in it. It's multiple thousands.
Yeah, it's like anything. Just... send over a file and get it 3D printed.
Yeah. Oh, someone's died outside. Okay. If we look at the overall standings, the gap between first and last place is 53 points. And every player has the potential to get 105 points on the last week.
Yeah. So it's anyone's game.
Absolutely anyone's game to make it into the top four in round two. So, for all the arguments as we discussed on last week's podcast of Duncan, like, oh, Ryan's going to win the competition that he created, the bastard.
Hmm.
No, I could make it into the top four and then immediately lose in the playoff stage. It can easily happen, especially when the rules change, which, that'll all happen. But that's a preview of the board because we run a week behind for the Fantasy League just because of
take the edit and shit.
Yeah, basically. Remember, this is a hobby and not a full-time job. If it was a full-time job, probably Fantasy League would be out on the Monday.
But yeah, it's... Yeah.
But no.
Yeah. Eddie, nobody got time for that.
No, we haven't got a team of editors. There's a bunch of us around who may or may not have free time. That's how it is at the moment. But, you know, looking forward to that. But we will come back to the LEC later, because that's going to be the news topic. Because we're going to get like a quicker bits of news out of the way. Like, TennoCon Live happened this weekend.
Yes,
more clapping from D, of which one of the big announcements were sort of threefold actually, if you think about it. Oh, there's a that'll get cleared. The first is the new Warframe, which name eludes me.
Re something or other. It's the she's basically bits and pieces.
The skeleton Warframe.
She was built by the community.
They provided designs and the community ended up getting them in, and sort of the designs that were in there.
It looks freaking freaky as hell.
Yeah.
It looks cool, but looks freaky. The other thing was what's going to happen after Deadlock Protocols?
The next big open world area, which is
the
Heart of Deimos.
Yes, the Heart of Deimos.
Ah, there we are. Chaku. Chaku. Chaku.
Yeah.
So that's two big things. The third is the fact that there are another two Warframes coming out, including a Warframe that's now going to have two words as its name. Because you've got Chaku, you've got Wraith, and then you've got The Alchemist.
Yeah, and obviously with Heart of Thingy, we was also getting the infested free roam planet. It was a big chunk of that.
Indeed.
It looks shiny. It looks
very
fun.
Shiny.
It looks.
And
very
I
shiny
like
and
the
very
I like
fun.
their unique take on day night cycle as well. It isn't actually a day night cycle. It's the never ending war between two giant worms. One grants darkness to the place and the other grants light to the place. Well, it's a day-night cycle. Also, the fact that even though it has a fixed open-world planet, it's going to be procedurally generated underneath.
Yeah, it can shift and move around because it's the infested.
Yeah. So it's
taking the infested lore into account. The fact that they would be destroying tunnels and things would collapse and shift around because of what the fucking they're up to. And the fact that the planet's decaying.
Yeah. And the other big news on that is that we suck at Tenno Trivia.
Yeah. I was only there for like the last quarter of it.
Yeah, and I was there for the whole bit and ended up worse than if I didn't answer the questions. Because it had a you don't know Jack feel to it, so it was when you locked in an answer, it was worth a certain amount of points. And if you got it right, you got the points. If you got it wrong, you lost the points.
Mm-hmm.
And you could go into negative.
Yeah. I was
minus 50,000 points later. I'm really disappointed.
I was at like plus 30.
Oh. Go D. You finished in the top percentiles. I didn't.
No, I wasn't even in the top percentiles. I was in the top 100,000.
Yeah. Right. And I was at 180,000. So. Meh. Other little bit of news is rumours that EA want to buy out Warner Brothers gaming division for the usual, as known by Jim Sterling, one of the people that we watch every now and again, Unichronic Arts. They'll probably just buy it, make a couple of games, say the failures, and close them down.
Liquidize it. Just so it's got less competition.
Yeah. Right. Competition is good. Because, to be honest, at this point, if no one wants to buy an EA game, they can buy another game and keep the gaming industry going. But if all that's there is EA games and you don't want to buy an EA game, you don't get anything.
Well, it's like the...
again, I don't know business.
It's like Disney just eats.
Yeah, but they ate Marvel and they gave us the cinematic universe, so.
But still, it's basically there's a few companies that are trying to eat everything and control so they can control the market and flow.
Yeah, but monopolies just monopolies aren't meant to exist. It's just how it is.
But it's the way it's leaning towards.
Yeah.
It's just sad, but harsh truth.
Mm.
It's getting monopolized. Yeah. It's basically who has the most money. Oh, we do. Then we buy out you, and you, and we like you, so we'll keep you, but we're going to scrap you, and you.
Mm.
It's basically they monopolize what content and what you can see, what's going to get developed. Oh, yeah, that's a really cool idea. No. It's...
Well, I'm on the idea of trying to tone it down about a particular company, but that'd be you'd be known as pulling a Sergey.
Oh. Okay.
Anyway, enough of that company that I'm not going to spend all my time talking about.
Okay then.
Let's move on to what's been played.
Oh, I really haven't been playing much. Played out.
You've played PC Building Simulator in real life. Sorry, you were talking about Ark.
I briefly played Ark a little bit with Steph, and then it crashed and corrupted itself. So that was another 220 gig download.
Oh, Ark.
Yeah, it booted me off. And
is,
then...
is that still classed as early access?
I think it's in beta.
It's only in beta because they got microtransactions, right?
I'm not sure.
Let's have a. I'll have a quick look. You keep talking.
Else, what else have I been playing? I was playing something the other day, but like for life of me, cannot remember what it's called. Talked about Get Even last week.
Mm. Just so you're aware on this, Ark is a full release now.
Okay.
Bum, bum, bum,
bum. There's so many maps now, though. It's getting kind of ridiculous, but it's kind of fun. It's just the fact that it's so huge.
Mm.
And each map is like another 40 gigs. It's like, oh, yeah, look, here's a shiny new map for you to play. Now, do you have the 40 gigs hard drive space for it? Oh, by the way, we've still got the other hard drives.
So. Don't pull a Phantasy Star Online with me. Don't do it.
Well, you can't
just delete your game, but if you can just reinstall another 240 gigs, that'd be great. I don't have the space anymore.
Well, I don't know if you want me to talk about specs or not.
You've got a lot of hard drives. I remember that much.
I'm going to have to take two of them out. The 2 1-terabytes, because they don't fit. They're just in the bottom of the case rattling around.
Oh, dear.
It's set to have 2 SATA drives and 4 SSDs.
Right.
I've got 1 SSD and 4 SATA drives.
Hmm.
So there's no physical space for them. They're meant to be mounted to the side of the board. There's a place where you can see where the mounting screws are.
Hmm.
But it's designed for SSD, and SSD is about yay big. Instead of, like, yay big. And weigh a ton. And one of them is way overheated. The Hitachi. It's running at over 150.
Okay, right. But hold on. You've got 7 fans in there.
Give or take.
Wow.
One sec. 3 at the front, 2 on the top, 1 at the back, 1 for the PSU, 1 for the CPU, 1 for the card.
That's 9.
I think that's it.
You've got more fans than case.
I actually need to switch 2 of the fans up because the airflow is just going to go inside itself. I need to switch the airflow around. I kind of twigged. It's all just going to go in a giant cycle and nowhere for it to escape.
Too many fans.
It's only 9.
Only 9.
What? I've got another 4 over there if I want to put them in. If I had the cabling for it. And the space.
Anyway, what else have you been playing?
Not a lot, really. been playing LoL and stuff.
Yeah.
We've
gone to Spirit Blossom event.
Yeah, I've been doing the Spirit Blossom event. With the Spirit Blossom event, I'm doing quite well, actually.
That's cool. Just so anyone who doesn't know what the Spirit Blossom event is, basically, do you like visual novels in your MOBA?
Yeah. And you find about... It's got a nice bit of story and lore a little bit. It's a bit twisted,
yeah.
Though.
Yeah, it's a bit more creative than some of the events they've had in the past, which were just complete missions, get tokens. In this, it's sort of generate bonds with each of the characters, and you're rewarded with a little bit of visual novel choicery and tokens.
Teemo's still a dick.
Teemo is always a dick.
He's been a bit to Thresh.
Who is characterized now as like the guardian of the spirit woods. As opposed to sort of keeper of the dead in the Shadow Isles.
He's basically, he sees the spirits as children.
Yeah.
Quote unquote.
Yeah, rather than souls as money, currency, whatever the fuck Thresh does. I don't know the law for Thresh much anymore. Last time I remembered, he was a record producer.
Yeah. But yeah, it's like Kindra is playing hide and seek with Wolf. And he's a child driven Reaper.
Riven seems to be a sulky sulk.
Riven's got amnesia. Her thing is she's got amnesia, and the blade that's broken, she's obsessively trying to recreate.
She doesn't want to do that. She doesn't want to do that.
I can ruin the ending for you if you want. I've got her S ranked.
Nah, it's fine. I'll get there and ruin it myself.
Because it was kind of like, oh, look. And I was like, oh. Learning about Leela, the new champion.
Yeah, the Scottish fawn.
Yeah, and we find out that Yasuo's brother's going to be coming in next week.
Yone will be coming in next patch, I believe.
He's
not next patch, or... The 6th. Oh, because Lily has only just come out, hasn't she? So...
There's a big update on the 6th. Due out.
Okay, so that will be...
Oh yeah,
that will be this patch then.
Yeah, the 6th is due out, and it's going to be should be a big patch because the lore and stuff that's going on inside.
Which I think sort of updates the Spirit Blossom event as well, because there is a Yone shaped hole on the top corner. So
I have a funny feeling it's coming out on the 6th.
Which would suggest if you do like animation, even if you don't like League of Legends, watch the animation preview for Yone and Yasuo. It's not a bad one.
Huh. I just love Jet Jinx. I like Jet Jinx. It's my favorite so far.
I mean, the music videos are sort of cool, and their sort of music division is pretty good. But yeah, sort of the animation team who did this sort of knocked it out of the park. So sort of give that an idea.
So did Warframe with the thingy last night.
Did they show the tutorial opening cutscene again?
They went through the first.
Well, they went through Heart of Deimos, but so the big thing is that they're updating the Vor's Prize tutorial story with a really, really, really good opening cutscene that was directed by the guy who directed 10 Cloverfield Lane.
They did snippets to try not to spoil too much, but they did cut to it and then go
the full cutscene, of Vor's Prize, or the opening of Warframe, has already been out. That was at TennoCon last year,
but now
it was just like, we got this big Hollywood director to do this animation, here it is.
But no, basically it was, they previewed it a little bit, and oh, that was the other thing that we need to learn about with the new patch for Warframe. Mm-hmm. The fact that the Warframes can get eaten.
Oh yes, basically the Heim Elf, is it the surgery chair that's in your ship?
It's going to get a little shrub of horrors attached to the back of it.
That is Heim Elf. It's not just the chair. That's actually the face that goes with it. And the idea that you can sacrifice Warframes to take a skill from one Warframe and put it onto another.
Yeah.
That are not the ultimate abilities.
Yeah. So.
And the fact that Jakku, or whatever it was called, is built by the sacrificing of other Warframes.
Yeah, it's basically, it's going to add a new, it's basically infested are finally getting their big old, here's a big chunk of infested.
Mm.
What so, they've really haven't had in a long time.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, to be fair, the infested, the last lore for the infested was sort of
Juggernaut.
Just sort of the origins of the infested is just that they were humans or Tenno that were infected by a plague and became the big grotesque horrors that you've come to know and love, hate.
Well, the Hard Deimos is going to explain a lot more about that.
Yeah, because of the, basically, for those who don't know sort of Warframe, there's child soldiers. Yes, I know that's a content warning right there. Mm-hmm.
That's what the Tenno are.
Yeah, which is an awkward thing to discuss. But you're space ninjas in giant suits of armor, and you do all this. But they were hidden in a place called the Void, and it turns out their powers, which is part of what Heart of Deimos comes from, their powers come from the Void, and in particular, the heart, which is a literal thing, and it's getting infected. And the storyline is basically, if that heart gets infected, all the Tenno are basically gonna.
Yeah.
We
need to try and keep the planet a thing, and they.
Yeah, the character just known as Mother.
Yeah, we need to basically help Mother out.
Keep her going, who's trapped in a flesh tower.
Well, the M's, they call it a flesh plane.
Yeah.
That's their code name for it, the flesh planes.
Yeah. So that's all there. I've been playing a lot of Gems of War, which is basically what the guys who made the Puzzle Quest games made instead. While they then sold off Puzzle Quest to D3 Infinite, I think, who then basically made them made Magic the Gathering Puzzle Quest and Marvel Puzzle Quest and sort of they're fine. They're not great, but they're fine. Gems of War, however, is okay. It's not Puzzle Quest, but it's good. That's there. Basically, if you like match three games that also have RPG elements, ta-da! Other than that, I played some more Nocturne, and I'm actually now out of the Armala network. So,
woo.
Yay! Turns out that whole thing last week that I got annoyed of, the fact that I lost about an hour and a half's progress, all I needed to do was not face the boss and turn left, and the save point and healing rooms were there.
Ah. That's more of a dip on you.
Yeah, exactly. The game's still got a difficulty level that could be best described as a upwards curve of a wall. Yeah, it's like, no, I mean, to be fair, the difficulty curve of the game is, all right, yeah, here we go, how do we do?
Yep.
When you face the first of the 12 skeleton people as well, that's going to be an annoying one.
Oh.
However, I'm back into it and I'm alive. It's all good, and hopefully I'll complete it by the time the HD remaster comes out next year.
Maybe.
Also played Warframe slightly, as we talked about TennoCon. They were doing an event for Twitch drops, so they provided a new hand cannon. If you watched the TennoCon, which was the sort of the panel-ish part, and for more than 30 minutes while your account was linked. And
get Hydroid.
And yeah, you got Hydroid Prime if you watch Tenno live for more than 30 minutes.
Mm.
Which was the Heart of Deimos preview. That's what they call Tenno live. But Dee, if you could just vamp for me and just talk about something for a second. Well, oh no, wait, the monitor's back.
Okay.
I'm actually just going to restart it anyway. If there's anything else that you want to talk about, just let people know.
Okay.
And I'll be just a moment.
Okay. What do I want to talk? Planning to get the Xbox Game Pass thing and play some of that stuff and do stuff like that. Well, it's going to be like Final Fantasy 15. Maybe. I'm planning on playing 15 and stuff like that. Yeah.
Apologies for that. My monitor was overheating. Did you get what you needed off your chest sorted there?
I just said that I've got the Game Pass and now I'm thinking of playing 15 sometime soon.
Oh, good. Good. And you can learn new recipes.
Yes, I can learn new recipes.
Perfect. Yeah, so I apologize about that. Apparently my monitor's decided it just likes to just overheat. Which, because it's got the preview for the podcast on there, it was kind of important that I kept it there.
Nine fans?
Yeah, can I borrow a couple of fans, please?
Got a few over there. That's not the case right now.
You got a few spare. I know, I mean, with...
I always mail them.
Don's applauding in the background. She's got one of a fan. Yes. Look, this new lockdown things, or not lockdown, but change to rules, is just sort of annoying. I mean, what you'll have to do is you'll have to turn up, drop the box with the fans there, knock on the door, and run. I mean, the running is optional, but...
Or I could just mail the damn things.
I mean, you could, but we're just down the road.
No, I meant... mail them.
Yeah, no, that's what I meant. You go to the door.
Mail them through the letterbox and then go chippy. Yay me.
But, yeah. So that's some games. And now we move to the main event of the podcast this week.
We've something had quite a bit of news. And the news hasn't been great this week.
New. So we, at the beginning of the podcast, or about 15 minutes in, we talked about the LEC.
Mm-hmm.
We talked about League of Legends. So,
Brief
bit of history for those who don't follow the esports side of the game League of Legends.
We're going to go into the Syria thing, aren't we?
It's Saudi Arabia.
Saudi Arabia.
It's close, but yeah, we'll get there. We'll get there. There'll be some history to give you this. So, League of Legends esports is split into various divisions in order to keep it a global event. It culminates in what's called the World Championships. But generally in the middle of the season, they also have something called the Mid-Season Invitational, or the MSI. Not to be confused with MSI, the chip manufacturer, or MSI, the installation software.
Oh, the MSI, my new case.
Yeah.
With a dead fan. I wasn't happy about.
Yeah. Hello, computer. Are you going to... monitor, are you going to do what you're doing? Good, you're still working? Good.
Took it to the icebox, it'll be fine.
Yeah. But,
yep.
What was I trying to say?
The new LEC is going global.
So there's a various divisions. So you've got the LCK, which is the Korean division. You've got the LPL, which is for China and other territories. You have the LCS, which is the League Championship Series, the original North American League. Mm-hmm. And then you used to have what was called the EU LCS, but to make it run off the tongue better, you got the LEC, the League European Championships. No, or the League of Legends European Championships.
That's the one that we're doing, isn't it?
Yeah, that's the one that we're following for the Immaterial Gamers Fantasy League. And basically, throughout that, there's various sponsors that are used. Mm-hmm. Like Alienware and KitKat and, some others, usually European banking companies and stuff like that. Those that want it to, get a bit of promotion and sort of legitimize the esport game.
Well, recognizing that it's a thing, and it's a it's a thing that exists.
Yeah. And so you've got that, and then you've got you have people called shoutcasters. They're the commentators. They're the analysis. They're the people who sort of they talk through the batshit crazy, undecipherable game that is League of Legends.
It's like the in football, it's the guys that sit in the thing at the top.
Yes. You've got the commentators there. You've got the pundits. They're the guys who sort of do the play-by-plays, and you got a color commentator and a player commentator there, like that. You've probably done this if you've done other esports, but it's the same for League of Legends. Now we have a timeline.
Okay.
Because this was the biggest controversy that's probably happened in esports since Evo got cancelled a couple of months ago because the guy who ran it was accused of sexual harassment. It's the year that keeps on giving.
Mm-hmm.
In terms of that, it's the year that people have decided, I've got nothing to lose, and I've had an awful experience with X, Y, and Z. It's about time people knew.
Mm.
So, we start off, like all stories, at the beginning.
No, not if you're Tarantino.
We're not Tarantino. So, we are back.
I've been, like, just doing random sounds for the last, like, little bit.
Thank you. Don't worry, that will get cut, so you don't have to look like you're crazy.
I'm just going, yeah, like,
yeah, so.
No, you're on hold, all technical line.
Yeah, so, let's think of it this way. What was the last weekend? So, we had the weekend of, there we go, the weekend of the 25th and the 26th of July. It should be known, briefly, that the LEC is sort of lauded upon esports of it being an inclusive league. Mm-hmm. And by that we mean that, you know, there are people of various, you know, nationalities, creeds, religions, gender, sexuality, identity, race, you know, mm-hmm. that goes through there. People sort of laud it on there as one of the things. So because of that, they had Berlin Pride. The studio for the LEC is in Berlin.
Mm.
In Germany?
I think so.
And they were celebrating Pride there. So the LEC had done what all the companies do and changed the colours of their logo to reflect
the rainbow.
Pride.
And various rainbows and stuff. It's like the
full Pride rainbow that they use. So, you know, it's the multicolour one plus the browns and the blacks and the white. The full Pride flag.
Full generic Pride, yeah.
Because
the amount of flags that we have is ridiculous.
Yeah, so the way that the community is in regards to that, and that says, you know, let's say Immaterial Gamers, there are various, you know, sort of identities that go there.
Mm-hmm.
It's up to them whether they want to explain it.
Yep.
You know, in regards to that, but just note that it is rainbow like the rest.
Yep.
However, the Friday the 29th, the Wednesday the 29th of July, I know calendar dates.
I know words, I think, maybe.
Yeah. So we got to list all these. I mean, a lot of stuff happened within like 48 hours, so just got to list them in the times that they are. Yeah. They're listing them in European time, so I've got to remove an hour off because we're doing this in GMT. It's probably the easy way to do it because that's the easiest way to sort of change time zones from there. So, 12:19 on the 29th of July. That was a Wednesday. Mm-hmm. LEC proudly announces that they have got a new sponsor. That sponsor is the Saudi Arabian megacity plan called NEOM, which means new future. If their thing is to be believed.
Yeah.
NEOM is one step of Saudi Arabia's Vision 2030 project, which is an idea of stating that they are going to sort out inclusivity and modernize the kingdom of Saudi Arabia.
Because
It's got a tarnished history. Let's be honest.
It's not fun.
Reliance on oil, gender sort of discrimination, and heavy, heavy homophobic nature.
Yeah.
Due to their interpretation of their religious beliefs.
Yeah.
I'm looking to be sort of as level-headed as possible as I can in regards to this, even though there's a lot of stuff that's happened that can't be level-headed. We will get to the specifics of why that's a problem as we go along.
Okay, I'll...
Don't worry, there'll be opportunity to discuss it. There'll be plenty.
I've just got to try and remember to keep my face in sort of like...
Mm-hmm.
Less of a scowl.
Yeah. At 12:20, on the Wednesday afternoon, they announce that NEOM is going to be the partnership. Oh, Vision 2030, by the way, is supposed to be, you know, all that inclusivity, and it's supposed to be less reliance on oil as their trade.
Yeah, because eventually oil's going to run out, dipshit.
Yeah, they know that, so they want to try and modernize that way. And I will say it now, as a concept, and in theory, Vision 2030 is sound. The problem is everything that goes around it.
Yeah.
And I've got experience on this in more than just the LEC. WWE. We'll just say that. We'll get back to that later on.
New day.
Rocks. I hope you saw in the general chat of the video that I put of the wrestler Big E entering the ring. Yeah, if you haven't seen it, you should have a quick look. While you do that, I'll just sort of explain on here. So within 7 minutes of that announcement, the production team and the casting team of the LEC individually start posting on their Twitter. It's apparent as you go along that this was a one-man decision to which no one else was even caught aware. You know, in terms of news, that if people who work for the company that makes the announcement know about the announcement at the same time as the general public, that is a bad thing.
Yeah, because that throws a massive sinkhole.
Yeah, it's already happened once this year with Mixer, their Microsoft streaming platform that they closed down. They announced that they were closing down within a week and they were going to become Facebook Gaming. Everyone at Mixer was told that after the public knew.
Yeah.
That's just insane.
That's bad.
It's insane. So
I'm not really going to go into how bad that fucking is.
It's bad. It's simple as. That'd be like, you know,
Oh, by the way,
that'd be like for Immaterial Gamers. That'd be like if I announced that we were shutting everything down and I was moving to Canada with everyone's money. I mean, that would be an hilarious joke because we don't have any. But yeah, no, that'd be like if I just told everyone and the first time that UD found out was on that press release, there and then.
Or after the fact, like, by the way, I'm going to Canada. When? I'm already here.
Yeah. What? Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah. If I've already moved over. It's like, oh, Ryan, you weren't around for the podcast. Why was that? My visa cleared. I'm already
in Canada.
Yeah.
And I'm living here now.
Yeah.
But,
so that's bad. So here we go. So yeah. Yeah. July 29th, 12:26. That's 7 minutes after the announcement. Members of the LEC broadcast team expressed their disapproval. This is according to the Liquipedia, or the LOL Gamepedia sort of wiki page, which has kept the timeline there and saved me a job. Thank you. I appreciate it. I will credit you. Yeah, so first off, Daniel Dracos. Yes, his screen name's the same as his surname. There have been many good days to be a member of the LEC team. Today is not one of those days. Then we move on to... where else are we here? Oh, yeah. 12:27. Aaron Medic Chamberlain. I cannot express how frustrated and disappointed I am with the LEC today.
Medic.
12:28. Indiana Froscure in Black. I am let down by the LEC today. This is important, and we'll sort of get back to that. This probably sums it up the best when it actually comes to it. 12:33, Chrissy Ender Freyerson.
Okay.
He wrote, fuck.
Yep. That about sums that up.
Yep. And then 12:40, Trevor Quickshot Henry posts an article by the Guardian newspaper explaining the human cost of the Neom megacity project, which involves taking tribes from Saudi Arabia and evicting them, either by giving them a generous pay or by violently getting rid of them.
Why does that surprise me?
Yeah. Then 1241, and this is the name that I knew I was going to get wrong for the podcast. Ifia Deportia goes by the handle of Shox. She's the basically the host when it comes to the LEC. I am terribly disappointed. Let's see. 10 minutes later, 12:51, Andrew Vedius Day. How very upsetting, LEC. These are all the casters individually standing by one another, just to go on this. Yeah. I've not seen this with a business for a long time. And then 1:04, we have Laure Vallée. I hope I pronounced that name wrong. Right. I hope I pronounced it right. If I've done it wrong, I apologize. Who's stated disappointment is an understatement.
Yeah.
They're the ones that come out on the timeline.
Mm-hmm.
People's comments on this went, hold on, the LEC is a bit of a hypocrite here, aren't they now? The LEC as an organization. It's like, how can you sit there and start throwing pride banners when you've just openly accepted a sponsor whose opinions on the LGBT community are murderous at best?
Yeah. I'm not even... Rage.
Yeah. You can be angry if you want, you know.
Not happy. But you know? It's one of the many countries that I'm not happy with right now.
Especially when we should explain on this, I mentioned frost curing.
Yeah.
Indiana Black is the openly gay member of the LEC community and was told of this at the same time as everyone else. Bad move, LEC. And I'm also being specific here, and I'm saying LEC, not Riot, because there is a little bit of autonomy between Riot, the game studio, who owns all these leagues, and the leagues themselves. They sort of operate for Riot at a point.
Basically get funded or whatever.
Yeah. They sort of basically, you're allowed to use our game.
Yeah.
Sort of make this league. And you know, they are part of Riot indirectly, but they are.
Like a shell, no, not shell, sister company or whatever.
In a sense, subsidiary is probably the thing. It's why LOL Esports is now its own separate thing. It's still part of the Riot service, and this is where, you know, people talk about hypocrisy. Here we go. So yeah, that's happened. All the LEC casters have turned around and said, we're not happy with this. Rioters, that's what they call the staff at Riot Games, rioters. Not like they've come out with a placard and stuff.
Grab your torch and pick, though
that being said, we did have the a couple of years back, we did have the gender discrimination lawsuit that happened at Riot.
Yeah.
And when rioters riot, that's still ongoing. There is still a settlement that's happened, but there's still stuff going on. There's still improvements that need to be made. And this isn't one of them improvements. Because then people started slagging off the production lead. I don't remember the name. I'm sorry, I've not done all the research, but I remember it when I was watching it. Because in fact, I still have it on my tweet deck of the LEC hashtag to see if there's anything that comes up, because there was stuff that needed talking about on this. Mm-hmm. And yeah, when the production lead says he had no idea and he's ashamed that they've still got this Pride logo while announcing Neom as a sponsor, you know, sort of threw things to shit. So yeah, community outrage, everything's gone on like that. July 30th at 2:35 in the morning, LEC confirmed that the partnership with Neom was terminated. So within, what we're looking there, 13 hours?
Yeah.
And it was a rough 13 hours. The partnership's terminated. And then out of the woodwork came the bots. And a lot of fans from the Middle East who now felt that they were being hard done by.
Mm.
So now every single one of those casters were now getting sent messages calling out their hypocrisy that they are working for Riot Games, which is a company that is wholly owned by Tencent, which is a Chinese company. And now they have their own problems. China, as a country, are in a point where they are being accused of genocide.
Mm.
I've forgotten what it is. And ethnic cleansing. There we go. That's the thing.
Cool.
There is a set of Chinese citizens that are, they're called the Uyghur tribe? Or the Uyghur Muslims. And China aren't exactly great on the supporting of Muslims problem.
Hmm.
I've got a message of concern from Don over there, but I am talking about what is publicly available. It's just it's in there in the news, and China have denied all these accusations and basically told the rest of the world to mind your own business. The slight difference on this, and this is a slight difference, but it's an important difference. Tencent, while being accused of being the gaming arm of China, are not making the decisions. Tencent, the gaming company, is not going out and killing people.
Mm.
Neom is owned or is a project run by Saudi Prince Mohammed bin Salman, who has been directly accused, and this is in the news as well, has been directly accused of killing a Saudi journalist in an embassy in America.
Ooh.
So, you know, that's a slight difference on there, but it's important to note.
Okay.
That, and then sort of the discourse and the hatred that's coming out from Twitter users towards what started off as all the LEC casters, and then classic internet treatment, you then aim for the women. Mm. And you sort of dismiss the male voices because they can stand up for themselves. They're the big boys. Go for the women because they can't do out. They can. Don't be stupid.
You're all right.
And then they've called out Black specifically.
Oh, dear.
Like we said, she's the openly gay caster for the LEC, and what better way to promote your own homophobia than go at the gay woman? Let me just call it out now. If you've done that, you're a fucking moron.
Yeah.
If you think that I'm going to be sitting there just like, oh, but you're like, oh, so we can't let all the LGBT people get all the things. It's like, shut the fuck up. That's your personal experience from me. If you don't like it, you're not watching us anyway, go fuck off.
It's just one of those.
So, you know. Yeah, it is one of those sort of things. I mean, do you seriously think that you're going to sit there and the openly gay member of the broadcast team is going to be happy to sit there and promote the country that if she ended up in there, she'd get beheaded?
Yeah.
Now, granted, that I mean the other ones on there, it's like, oh, China aren't much better. Yeah, about that, though, she's already been to China. They already hosted the Worlds there last year.
Hmm. But there's loads
she of... She came back in one piece.
Well, there's over 20... Or 20, I can't remember the thingy now. There's fuck tons of countries there. That's still a problem.
Yeah, Russia is one. I'd be interested to see what would happen if LEC or if Riot turned around and said that they would host the next year's World Championships in Sochi, for example. Mm. While homophobia or while homosexuality isn't punishable by death, it's
not great.
It's hated upon by the ruling party in Russia.
Yeah,
there's no denial of that. It's there in the news. If you read it for even just 1 second, you'll notice that there have been stories of for the Sochi Olympic Games of sort of openly gay athletes not really feeling comfortable with attending or sort of having to play down the fact of their actual sexuality because of the fact that they could get assaulted in the area and arrested for being gay.
Yep.
And, you know, people could just go, oh, this is just blah, 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 SJW virtue signature, blah, blah, blah. No, this is me as a human being with, with basic human standards. Saying my point here.
It's like the map. There's a weird map where you go, oh, look. I don't know if you think about it, but it's like, oh, look, these are the places we can't go now. Ding, 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 ding.
Oh, I think the meme on that would be sort of the Simpsons one where they finished a holiday and it shows that they're now not able to go on a holiday out of 50 out of the 52 states.
Because of something or other.
There's always some sort of incident.
Well, it's like...
Is it just Homer chalks it off or Marge just chalks it off with the Lex and it's just like, we can't go there now.
Well, it's like the... Even America's got some states where you got to be careful in the states you go to.
Yeah, and a lot of them on there, because there's the other thing on this is that people are going, oh, it's Islamophobia and you've banned us because we don't do this. And it's like, no, there are states, like you said, Dee, there are states in America that are highly, highly Orthodox Christian.
38? Oh, is it 38 states now?
A lot of the red states.
No, I think 38's okay. The rest are like, no.
Yeah, there's some that are just going to be...
No. Yeah, it's
the
rest of it.
Actually, I say red states on the fact that apparently, if we look at some of that, like Texas and sort of the big population centers in there are actually very, very inclusive in regards to that. But it's just the southern states, that have that sort of problem.
It's all over the place. It's not just one country. It's all countries have areas. Some places are good, some places are bad.
Yeah.
Even in you can go city by city.
Yeah.
Town by town, city by city.
Yeah. So we continue on this, by the way, because it doesn't stop there. Just because the partnership was ended, it didn't stop there. Like we said, people came out of the woodwork and started being very, very, very stupid towards the then diminishing amount of LEC casters. And, there were a lot of casters who said that they were taking a social media break because of this. Because, it's the same with anyone else. People are going to have the right to take a break. Just because you're a social media personality doesn't mean you need to respond to absolutely everyone that's on there. And, I guess, like say people are going, oh, yeah, but they wear Nike or they eat Nestle chocolate bars and why are they not doing anything with them, blah, blah, blah. There's only so many battles someone can fight before their head explodes.
Yep.
And that's, that's not to say that they hadn't been fighting them, as Shox had said, or as Aoife sort of said on tweets that had happened afterwards. It's like, you think that we haven't talked about this? And then there's slight differences that come up. Riot is a company that's owned by another company, and you can't change, the things on that. You can't change who you work for unless you just disappear and work for them, and people have suggested that. People suggest, Riot should just close down because that's the only way you can put a dent into China. It's like, China gives no shits.
It's freaking huge.
So,
it's one of the biggest conglomerates, ever.
Yeah. We talk about hypocrisy as well. People going off and it's like, oh, you work for Riot, you dickhead, blah, blah, blah. Oh, why would you support all this? Has a profile picture of a Valorant character. Hello. Valorant, just in case you don't know, D, is the first-person shooter made by Riot Games. If you want to just face palm, that's
okay. It's like look at products, 90% of products that we get made in China.
Yeah, and the branded stuff like your Nikes and stuff like that. Yeah, I guess that that is problematic, and that's child labor, and that is problematic, and that's a different sort of battle that we're trying to fight, and you've got to, that will come up. We had someone join for a second then.
Steph's technically here.
Steph's here. He's here in the middle of the absolute shit show that has been this weekend and the LEC sponsorship.
Mm-hmm. I hear.
I know about.
Yeah. Yeah. Crib notes. Saudi Arabia, bad. LEC, the company, bad. Casters being told by other people that they're bad. And we're not even on to like July the 31st yet. We're not even started the LEC games yet.
Yeah.
So yeah, July 31st, midnight and 7 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
In response to a web show by the former League of Legends partnership player, I Will Dominate, and caster Thorin, and their show The Crackdown, Crosscurrent confirms that the LEC broadcast team had refused to appear on their programming until the partnership was terminated. Mm. And that was in response to a comment that basically said, all these guys are doing are tweeting. I'm sort of just sort of, I've not watched the thing. I don't intend to because I'm not giving them the views. But yeah, so the comment was, oh, look at them. All they're doing is tweeting about it. They've not done anything. They've not argued with them in the back. And, you know, at the end of the day, it's just a tweet. And Frost sort of laid into them. And this tweet that had come up and said, I'm deeply saddened by the latest episode of Crackdown where my integrity and principle is called into question through speculation. So let me clear it up. The on-air talent declined to appear on broadcast until the deal was revoked. I did put my fucking job on the line. So that suggests that they said, oh, well, until they actually put the jobs on the line, why should we believe them? Let's just play games. So they did, you know, they threatened to strike and did. A couple of the, I say actually a couple, Medic, Chamberlain, decided, no, this isn't happening. I'm not going to be on the broadcast this weekend anyway, because even though the apology's there, it shouldn't have happened in the first place. I need time to get away from this bollocks.
Basically.
And they let him get away from the bollocks.
Yeah, because it's... Yeah.
And, yeah. We then lead to 5 o'clock, July 31st. Alberto Guerrero, director of esports for Europe. What that? EMEA? Europe, Middle East, eh? I don't know. Basically, he's director of esports for Riot. Addresses and apologizes for the partnership on the first LEC broadcast since its announcement. So he did a video sort of explaining, you know, we're sorry, we've offended women, the LGBT
plus
community, and the Middle East. Unfortunately, that was read as a non-apology. And actually, if I read the full statement, here it is, because I'm not putting in the video. We know that recently our actions hurt and alienated our community, particularly women, LGBTQIA+ individuals, and our players in the Middle East. And for that, we are deeply sorry. At the LEC, we believe in being inclusive and creating a more diverse landscape for everybody. We understand that some of you lost faith in us. Well, that's a fucking understatement. Mm. But we are committed to taking steps to earn back your trust. Until then, thank you for sticking with us.
Okay.
We offended people. Sorry? And yeah, people, you know, I understand on that. He has come out and went, my bad. Yeah. But it's happened before with other companies, and I guess now the whole point is, let's see if their actions happen. Let's see if suddenly, you know, Neom ends up in another partnership down the line somewhere. Maybe at Worlds instead. Don't do it at Worlds, that'll implode. Jesus Christ.
Uh-huh.
We need something good this year. Jesus. And yeah, it then led to, and I'll say this, I watch the... Sorry, go on, Steph.
See, I understand. Okay, have a go at... Yeah, they're being sponsored by basically a Neon that's... what?
Neom is basically just the project name that was given to a mega city. in essence, it was being sponsored by Saudi Arabia, the country, because everything in Saudi Arabia is...
Okay, fine enough. It's being sponsored by Saudi Arabia, but to be honest, are they turning around to league and telling them they can't have this sort of list, like the gays, lesbians, women, and all the rest of it on it? No, because at the end of the day, they're just giving the league money.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, that's paying their wages. If they were to complain about it that much, that they were to complain and then not have a job because they have no one else to fund them, fair enough.
You have activated my trap card. We will now talk about the WWE. Sorry, guys. Like I said, from experience, this has happened before. The slight difference on this is that the LEC cancelled their partnership with Neon. WWE are still happily running it. They were actually funded directly by the monarchy in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. They weren't sponsored by Neon.
It's the whole issue of being sponsored by someone to the sponsor controlling them.
Yeah, but that's, I guess this is the thing. Okay, the argument on that then is that surely they're just being given money. The argument for then people is that they consider it blood money, money earned at the expense of the cost of lives.
Okay, then most money that comes from Africa is blood money. If they want to have that argument. So in other words, nothing in Africa could sponsor it.
Okay. See, your sort of devil's advocate
at,
on this.
At the end of the day, it's money. Money is the devil itself. Mm. If they're giving your company money to continue doing what they're doing their own way, don't complain about it. It's if they're giving them money and then saying, you can't have the women, you can't have these gay presenters, you can't have these lesbians, you can't have these other players, that's when you draw the line.
Yeah, and I guess that's probably where sort of the concern has come in on this, because what is to say down the line that they got that money from Neon, they built that city a few years down the line, League of Legends still exists, and then they host the next championships in Neon.
Oh, it's a big, like...
Now, still going on the fact that, say, Vision 2030 goes ahead, but they don't change their stance on homophobia. Therefore, you've lost members of the casting team because they can't go over there.
True.
I mean, we're talking worlds here as well, so there's probably some LEC, LPL, and LCK casters that are also LBGT.
The city itself has to go, we'll put them under protection while they're here, or just don't have it there. And Riot can happily turn around and go, we're not having it there because of them reasons.
But the thing is, I guess on this,
doesn't
Steph,
mean that Riot has to sit there and go, yes, we'll have it there because you're our sponsor.
Yeah, but you see, these are all the questions that should have been asked prior to them just randomly turning up and going, here's a sponsorship.
Oh, yeah, because somewhere down the line, they're going to ask for something.
Yeah,
it's going to be for something.
And that's what happened with the WWE on there. They got the foot in the door.
The better thing is, you might never know, the city itself might be trying to use this as a thing of, we're going to be like the savior in our country for people like that.
Yeah, it's just that the Saudi Arabia's track record has not been great. I mean, like we say, I'll go back to the WWE as the example on this. They paid like WWE like $100 million or something over a 10-year contract to host their pay-per-views over there. And they were doing it initially. A couple of wrestlers wouldn't turn up. One is of Syrian heritage, so would have got stoned for even turning up. Because unfortunately, on that point, it's evidence the tolerance is low. Mm. Like we said, we mentioned the journalist thing that happened like 2 weeks before the pay-per-view, and half the roster decided, fuck that, we're not going. And then on the next pay-per-view, it turned out that Saudi Arabia skimped on the payments. So good old Vinnie Mac cut the pay-per-view early over in Saudi Arabia, and it led to a diplomatic incident where a whole bunch of wrestlers were stopped from leaving on a plane. that was quoted as originally saying it was just aeroplane problems. And to every of the other wrestlers who was actually there saying, well, you weren't there, and they basically kept it grounded until they, you know, until they solved the business.
Mm.
And it had to, led to a really awkward, like, televised show afterwards of none of the people who were supposed to be there being there because they were still flying back to America.
Mm.
So Saudi Arabia are not, like, they're not, like I said at the beginning of the thing, in theory, Vision 2030 will work. Without actually showing any proof of change, no one's going to believe that.
Mm.
And just to sort of wrap up this whole thing, I score the LEC matches for the Fantasy League as live as possible to watch the games. But I don't put the Twitch chat on. And there's a lot of features in the LEC broadcast where you vote by spamming the Twitch chat. I saw something on there. It's like, yeah, the Twitch chat's more out of order than normal. And yeah, looking at moderators like trying to ban people as quickly as they popped up like fucking whack-a-mole asking for the literal head of a LEC caster.
Hmm.
Yeah, you lose my sympathy at that point. Everything I would have had on there, I would have been like Steph and went for the sort of the diplomatic approach. This isn't great. They announced it badly. They should cancel it for now. Double check for change. Bring it back when everyone's sorted and there's proof of progressiveness. They didn't show that in the chat. They showed it to be petty. Went on the idea of, no, you work for this Chinese company and they kill all these, they call these people of race. We're only asking you to let us kill the dead, the gay people.
Mm.
Sling your rock.
Mm.
Prove of the progressiveness or don't bother.
It's just how they're going to...
At the end of the day, they won't be able to prove it.
Mm.
No matter what they do, they won't be able to. They won't have the confidence.
Well, yeah,
no one would have the confidence to believe it.
Yeah, I guess it's to say at this point, I would be, and I think we would all be heavily surprised if we saw LEC X Neom as a post in the next few years at all.
Mm.
Or, you know, sponsoring anything like that. But yeah, well, you know. Like I say, we summon this up. You pick your fights. You read the room, and you know. I understand at that point. Yes, the LEC is a business, but make sure you got the right business deals, Jesus. Because I mean, like I say, at this point, I mentioned again earlier at the beginning of the podcast, this was a Sergey decision. You know, this is one person in the company who said, shall I discuss it with everyone? And there might be some issues.
See, that's more the issue I think they've had there. That one, he's basically turned around and gone, yeah, we'll take that.
Yeah, because I mean, like I said, we looked at the stuff.
Board meeting or team meeting with the whole team to see what they think and to at least go over everything with them.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, that was a thing that had come out as a rumor. There's supposed to be agreement between the teams taking part in the league itself in regards to sponsorships to make sure that everyone's comfortable with the sponsors that are being made on there. It didn't happen, I believe. Ocelot, who is one of the co-founders of G2, turned around and basically said, just for, you know, the avoidance of doubt here, stop saying I would have took the blood money because it wouldn't have happened.
Mm.
So there was a possibility that teams would start dropping out.
Mm.
And I guess at that point, when that happens, you really have no other option but to backtrack. And I'll give it this, at least the LEC backtracked. The thing with the WWE is they're still taking money and there are less and less people wanting to go over to Saudi to do the events in the first place.
Hmm.
you know, it sort of it becomes diminishing returns to a point where they then look at the deal and think, is this worth continuing? Currently, at the moment, for WWE, they still think yes. But yeah, that's a highly politically charged podcast. Sorry, I mean, it's a bit dark there as well. How do we brighten this up?
I don't know, but I'm looking at the proposals for the last few tournaments of LEC, the LCS, and 200k?
Yeah.
100k?
Yeah.
And I love the fact most of it is Fnatic in G2, but...
Yeah. I mean, to think into that, to take that into account as well, that's the prize bonus. They are also salaried. So you get money for turning up. Just like a football contract, but you get a prize pool as well.
Yeah.
So yeah, they're richer than we are.
Most people probably would.
Yeah, I was supposed to be thinking of like higher stuff, wasn't I? Warframe's cool.
Yeah, Warframe's gonna look.
From TennoCon, yes.
Yeah, August 25th. That'll be a cool day.
I was happy to say I was on the release to see the mother and everything else.
I
didn't have Warframe installed, so I was just watching the Twitch bit.
I was too busy watching the bloody TennoCon event that I forgot about the relay.
What was it? I actually watched something on Twitch last night.
Yeah, well, that's
wow. I'm not saying wow about that. I've just gone onto Kickstarter, and the first thing that came up for me was this face mask that's using gold and silver filters.
What?
Gold and silver filters. It's like that mask's worth more than the fucking...
That mask is literal money.
Yeah.
So, you know what? With that, we will wrap that up there then.
Hold on, let me see how much like the minimum backup is.
Oh, actually, yeah, we can't go until you said that. Go on, what are the tiers?
For $39 or more, which is about 30 quid for us, you get a 34% off retail price.
Wait, hold on. So you're already paying 40 or 30 quid to get money off?
Yeah, hold on. This also includes one outer shell with Cooler Tech, a gold/silver filter main, a gold, wow, you went really red there, gold and silver extractal filter, and an N95 filter. Don't know what fucking hell an N95 filter is. That's for,
make a model of it.
That's from anything from, let's say, 30 quid to 50 quid. Because the next one's 50 quid, where you get two masks, by the looks of this. The top one didn't even say, oh yeah, you get one breeze mask. You get two breeze masks for this. Two filters. Well, two reusable and four reusable. I don't know what the between it is, the main filter and the extractor filter. I'm not sure. Oh, there's basically two layers to the filter system you've got. By the looks of this.
There's just too much.
With that, you get to choose your colour. For that, that's for 50 quid to £75. God, they've got quite a few. This goes all the way up to 200 odd quid.
This is an idiot's mask, isn't it?
It's funny. Depending on the filter, you're probably worth more to sell it as gold than it is to fucking get the mask.
Wow. So we will wrap that up now then. So yeah, if you liked what you heard and are not immediately depressed, do what Steph's about to look at.
The extraction filter is the thing. No, the little things that go on the end.
Yeah, it's the little.
It's the little
caps.
Bit that goes in it. It's the filter bit that goes in that.
Oh, they can get fucked. They can get fucked.
And by the way, by the looks of this, it comes in silver, bronze, and gold.
Like, share, and subscribe, and don't buy that mask. Don't be an idiot. And thanks to Dee and Steph and Ryan. Oh, yippee. Sign me up. And don't sign me up.
And by the sounds of this, it basically has climate controls for your breathing, so it'll always keep the air around there cool and refreshing.
All I need to do is keep my germs from heading to someone else and stop their germs from heading to my face.
And it stops 99.8% bacteria.
Dettol does 99.9%. They've lost already.
Would you want to use that as a filter?
No. Anyway, yeah. You can watch the vidcast on YouTube and all the other vidcasts and other podcasts that are there. But you can also listen to them on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, and wherever you get your podcasts. And that yappy dog is going to get clicked. Anyway, thank you for listening. And thank you for watching. Bye.
Bye.
Yeah. I still feel like you're paying for these masks, by the way.